other you and I are probably inside the factory. On our way up to the first level.
And what happens if we run into ourselves?
We will.
How do you know that?
Because we did.
Whoops. Fuck. No! Oh. You fucking piece of shit. God damn it.
Service. I will not hurt the boy. I will see Fink and Comstock burn, but I will not hold the son to account for the deeds of his father.
You've misunderstood us.
We neither asked you to harm the child.
Nor did we promise that yours would be the hand that would set Comstock's world afire.
A famous man once said.
And a famous man shall say.
I may reach the mountaintop.
But I fear I shall never visit the valley below.
But you mean I won't live to see it? No.
It's up to you what matters more.
Your part in the play.
Or the play itself.
Someone is coming.
She'll arrive a girl.
She must leave a woman.
And what makes the difference between a girl and a woman?
Blood.
Your part in the play.
Or the play itself.
Turn her into a killer.
Ha. Give the girl no choice.
And she will be forced to make one.
That guy did. He's fucking twerking.
people smell dead air. Fear. Hatred. People die every day. But how many more will suffer if you rather? Violence begets violence, I know this. I've seen this. The rational mind argues for a peaceful solution to find a common ground. What common ground is there to find for a father who watches his child bleed out on the street? He denies his vengeance. I know that fire that burns deep inside. I know it all too well. When the time comes, will I be able to stay at hand? State of being, or lack thereof, has left my brother unfulfilled. The biological urge to leave one's mark is strong, and it is not an impossibility. We could instantiate ourselves back in Colombia, return to old life for the possibility of creating new. But we died in that world. Return may mean giving up part of us. Ourselves. We become flesh and all that it is heir to. The mysteries of the universe would become once again. Mysteries.
My guess is that it has something to do with that giant clock out there. And that clock has something to do with opening the door to Fink's lab. Certain activities when Fink gives us blessing.
So what? We're stuck waiting for the computer to go off?
No. We've already found the clock. We can manually wind it. Open whatever door we please.
She seems like a lot of work to lock down a few doors.
And if there's one thing Fink loves, it's a problem.
Able profit, untold profit. Keep the sales pitch, I'll provide the snake oil. Thank you.
Joseph. Let me place myself in the camp of the agnostic. I pretend to understand the mysteries of the infinite no more than you, Comstock, or anyone else for that matter. For the sake of argument, let's say this is all one unhappy accident, and we are all alone in our toil. Then who would Comstock use to control and shame us with rules that apply only to those without a penny in their pocket? If there were no God, you could rest assured the first deed done by the first rich man would be invented here.
Interesting. A lot of Bioshock lore in just that one very room.
Good. Look at that idiot's lock of hair.
Well, that was fucked up.
Look, are you there? I miss you. You're the only one I've ever. You're my only friend. Look,
over. I'm a fixture. I'm a projection in the mural.
Did you hear me then? Please.
I Oh man, the gameplay is just not fun. Really disappointing. God damn it.
I understand why they get you to play as Elizabeth, but I don't understand why they keep it going for so long.
Make note of that. 8371. So my phone is unbelievably slow. A 3, a 7, a 1. God damn it.
Fuck, fuck, fuck. Six, seven. Christ. I definitely want to find the hair sample, but I also definitely want to see what's in here. Whoops. What? Could have sworn it was 8371. Shit.
Comstock promises there's nothing to be worried about. But I don't like the smell of things down in Fictum. Not one bit. If trouble rears its ugly head in the form of one cantankerous negress, I've laid in some supplies in the event of a forced evacuation. They're down in what I call my chamber of panic, near the base of my statue. I've set the code to 8371.
Right, so this is just not even the right thing. Okay. Jeez. So I can need to get to that. Gamma.
Suchon sharing their research.
After the tests. Cross-reality collaboration. It all makes a kind of sense. The little sisters and the big daddies. Songbird and me.
Constants and variables.
It's a wire mother. If you separate a gorilla from its real mother, it will imprint in almost anything. Even that.
Why would you think you care about that?
Songbird. She wanted him to imprint on me.
Well, if I recall, that was a problem he solved.
That's the chemical that bonds mothers to children, women to men, and...
Songbirds to little girls?
Apparently not. Fink dismissed it as an unsuitable vector. These poor things. Fink couldn't get them to imprint, so he left them to die. Imprinting failed. I can't believe. Clearly they formed a connection between Songbird and me. I was so young then. I always remember him just being there. must be a prototype or something. Doesn't matter. On the film. It's me. My God. I remember. He crashed into the tower. I guess he was in some sort of fight. I waited there thinking, I don't know, that something would happen, but he just lay there. Moaning. This must be the genetic sample Suchar wanted.
He sent you all the way back here for a sample of your own hair.
He doesn't know I was once the child that imprinted on Songbird. But to him, all the answers lie in DNA. Men like Suchar must take an ounce of empathy for a pound of science.
This is a terrible place to be. I'm so screwed. Wait. Why did they start killing each other then like that?
It has occurred to me that this breakthrough regarding the songbird casts my arrangement with the Oriental Doctor in a new light. What more could be gained by this continued partnership? What secrets that I could not answer for myself? Sweet John can only offer table scraps. Jeremiah, I think, has a richer meat in mind. there's been some concern about the nature of the work we do here from manufacturing. Some say they're uncomfortable with the purported harm and suffering our research brings. But friends, let me pose a simple question. Is there anything you would not do to guarantee the health and safety of your loved ones? My interest is the future health of your children. An ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure.
Sea slug anatomy. Pain in the booty all of this has been. Care about Fink's treasure trove or whatever the fuck it is.